Hello. It comes to my attention that I have not been reviewing that many books lately because this is just becoming like a big meme channel. But I have been reading, I'm reading Wolf of Piccolo right now and a couple other books, Butcher's Crossing, I'll get to that later. But I would like to review two books I read recently. Salem's Lot is pretty famous. The other book I'm reviewing, Nada, by Jean-Patrick Manchette, is not as famous. If anyone hangs over and wants to hear about a more obscure title, then they can do that. So here I was just minding my own business, reading The Dark Tower. I read book four and then I go on the forums. I Google. Some people say you need to read a lot of books and some people say you don't need to read that many other books. But there was consensus that before you start book five, you should probably read Salem's Lot because a major character in book five is in Salem's Lot. It's kind of fun going from later Stephen King compared to early Stephen King. Salem's Lot was Stephen King's second novel after Carrie, and it's about a town getting infested with vampires. And I really enjoyed how the book treats the vampires like disgusting little devil monsters, which they are. And it's like a virus, that infects the town. There's one king vampire who comes into the town and just gets everyone. It's kind of like looking at Dracula at the extreme end of things. Like, what if Dracula had been really successful? But back to the comparison of old Stephen King and new Stephen King, there is a definite like roughness and a kind of unpolished quality to Salem's Lot and to earlier Stephen King. I find Stephen King really gets like better at writing later on, and that's a subjective opinion. Some people really love his earlier work more, and I get the appeal, but on like a word-by-word basis, just like prose-wise, it's very smooth later in his career compared to early on, which there are some inconsistencies, some clunky phrasing, paragraphs that feel kind of stitched together compared to later Stephen King, which is just a nice, smooth glass of whiskey, I guess, or whatever beverage. I would say that the first half of the book is pretty slow. The main characters aren't super engaging. Ben Mears, he's another Stephen King writer character, definitely not as interesting as Jack Torrance. He's just kind of like a stand-in for the audience at some point. His relationship with Susan is simple, sweet, but it serves its purpose. It's like, okay, we aren't here for this relationship. The character that I found most fascinating and most interesting, unfortunately, did not get a huge amount of screen time, and that was Father Callahan. Thankfully, we get to see him more in Wolves of the Kala, which I'm really enjoying. I feel like when Stephen King is writing Father Callahan's POV, he just kind of gets immersed. We follow a ton of different characters in the town, little snippets, just kind of snapshots of people's life. There's the good people in town, there's the really crappy people, really abusive people, there's some weird love triangles, just all sorts of drama that happens under the surface of a cozy little main town. So when everything starts going to hell with these vampires, a lot of people don't even notice. A few people come together, they try to stand against evil, and I'll leave it at that because I don't want to spoil anything. I feel like if I read it again, I would appreciate the slower scenes early on in the book a bit more because there's a lot of good payoff at the end. I enjoyed it. Now I want to review a book I read. It took me just a couple hours to read. It was a short read, but damn, it was good. I heard about this book on Better Than Food channel, which is a great channel for finding some more obscure books. It's just been a great resource for me for finding authors and titles that I've never heard of. One of his videos, he recommends Nada by Jean-Patrick Manchette. I think I'm Manchette. I don't know. And I was interested in this book because it's about a heist, sort of, and it's about a kidnapping done by a group of anarchists. It's set in the 70s after this kind of revolutionary fervor in the 60s. There's a lot of hopes and dreams, and these characters are desperate. They're at the end of this cresting wave of revolutionary spirit. One of the characters in particular feels like a violent act is justified. It's set up like a classic crime book, but there's a tension between ideas. Fortunately, the writing was crisp, fast, felt like you were watching like a classic French noir film like Rififi. Obviously, I mean, like, this isn't a spoiler because this is just part of the genre. It all goes to shit. When it does, it is spectacular, violent, bloody, and a little heartfelt at the end. If you want to see a little historical perspective of France in the early 70s, fun, action. I read it in like 3 hours and I really couldn't put it down. Even when I was supposed to, I should have put it down at some point, but I kept reading. These characters are not nice people. They are causing harm to themselves, to their cause, and to their country. Yet, on the other hand, we see how cruel and violent and vicious the law is. Just fascinating. I really enjoyed it and I'm really glad I picked it up. And I'm definitely going to read another book by this author. I already have books on hold. Yeah, thanks for watching.